It's January 2021, and this is the Library Roadshow. On the show today, resolutions, online learning, and One Book, One Community. Welcome to the January edition of the Library Roadshow. I'm Mary Stein, and this is a production of your East Baton Rouge Parish Library System. I think I speak for everyone on the planet when I say good riddance to 2020 and welcome to a new year. But it wasn't all bad. We made some COVID lemonade and learned all about virtual programming, and thousands of you spent a little time learning about the library's fabulous digital resources. I'm proud to say that thanks to you, the library has cracked the 1 million ebook download ceiling. Keep up the good work. Download all you want. We'll get more. But don't forget that physical books, magazines, movies, music, and audiobooks are just a short visit away. The drive-through window at the main library at Goodwood, as well as at the Fairwood branch, are open daily. Plus, you can call to schedule lobby pickup at any branch if you don't want to come inside to browse. We've even begun to schedule in-person programs and hosting community meetings. Our Spring One Book, One Community series will launch on February 20th with an in-person visit from National Book Award winner Sarah Broom, author of The Yellow House. She'll be joined by Margaret Wilkerson Sexton, author of The Revisioners. Seats will be limited, so we'll take reservations. We've gathered a host of resources in the special info guide on the website. More on that next month.
Free access to books, audio, and library resources are just a few of the benefits available to you when you get a library card. Need free access to a computer? You get that. Want free access to premium digital resources like Mango Languages and Lynda.com? You get that. Need to book a meeting space? You get that. Heck, you can even check out a telescope or use a digital printer with your library card. If you live in East Baton Rouge Parish, pick up your free library card from your local branch library today. Premium access to everything the library system has to offer is waiting for you.
We make a lot of resolutions each new year, and while we can't come to your house to coach you daily to keep most of them, there is something we can offer, and that's easy access to skills development that can make a huge difference in your life. I'm talking about Lynda.com. Adam St. Pierre shares more in the digital download.
Are you ready for 2021? This is going to be your year, and the library is here to help you make it your year. How, you ask? Lynda.com from LinkedIn through your library. Lynda.com provides all sorts of fantastic video courses and learning paths that will help you become your best self this year. Lynda.com learning paths curate courses for you to achieve your professional or personal dreams with a wide variety of programs, programming languages, and soft skills. Here's just a few for your inspiration. Ace the Basics, Adobe Photoshop, Illustrator, and Premiere Pro. Master After Effects. Become a Programmer, Foundations. Master Product Design with Fusion 360. Become a Python Developer. Play the guitar. Or develop your project management skills. And all of that is free with that library card. To check out Lynda.com, head over to the digital library page at ebrpl.com.
This premier online resource leads the pack for online learning for adults, but it's not the only tool in our digital toolbox. Udemy is my new favorite, with thousands of quick, on-demand mini courses waiting for your convenience, plus our old classic Gale Courses, which delivers instructor-led courses. These take you through 6 weeks of classes on topics that range from business and skills development to leisure courses, as well as courses that help you with health, lifestyle, and even consumer topics. Plus language learning from Mango and Pronunciator. Find out more by visiting the online learning info guide or by watching short introductions for each resource in the Library Academy. Just head to the homepage and click that tutorial tab on the far right. Let's shift gears and check in with Kayla Perkins, reporting in from Beyond the Stacks.
We've come up with new ways to keep our younger patrons engaged with their library during this time, through crafts and creativity. We're at the Greenwell Springs Road Regional Branch to talk to Ashley Clark about the popular grab-and-go kits. Let's check it out.
Hi, Kayla. Mm-hmm. I'm Ashley Clark. I am the head of the Teen Services Department here at Greenwell Springs Road Regional Library. And we're here today to talk about our grab-and-go programs that we're offering.
So, Ashley, what is a grab-and-go kit and where are they available?
They're available at every single location. They're grab-and-go kits for teens and for 20-somethings, ages 18 and up. Children's is doing something similar as well, but they call theirs Saturday Shenanigans. And a grab-and-go kit has everything that you would need for whatever project we're offering. So, for example, starting next week, we're offering this Among Us hand warmer. And it'll have a template, the felt, the needles, the thread, everything that you need to make this project at home on your own. And we have video tutorials that accompany every project.
So are the grab-and-go kits something new that the library is offering? And if it is, why?
Okay, so yes, we had to pivot in March with this whole pandemic. So we still wanted to offer as many library services as we could. Because it's not the safest thing right now to do in-person programming, we're offering as similar an experience as we can in a safe and socially distanced way. So we've been doing them since we came back in May, and we now have over 100 projects that we've done. You can find out what we're offering each month by checking our online calendars. We advertise them on our Facebook page, which is East Baton Rouge Parish Library Teens. They're available to see on Instagram. We're EBRPL Teens. And we occasionally will repeat programs, like we share at the different branches. But there's always something new coming out, and there's a variety of things. So it's not all going to be crafts. There's like STEM things as well.
The possibilities for hands-on creativity at the library really are endless. To find out what's coming up next, pick up a copy of our monthly newsletter, The Source, or visit us online at www.ebrpl.com.
Thanks, Kayla. There's plenty of fun ideas floating around to keep us busy. Stay right there. After the break, Library Director Spencer Watts joins me for a chat right here on the Library Roadshow.
I'm Zoe Kravitz from Fantastic Beasts, The Crimes of Grindelwald. Books are magical, and reading can transform your life. Libraries make sure people of all backgrounds can experience the wonder of literature through literacy programs and access to media. Spread the magic by supporting your library.
You're watching the January edition of the Library Roadshow, everything you need to know about your local library system. And speaking of the library system as a whole, I'm happy to start off the new year with a visit from our library director, Spencer Watts. Okay, Spencer, COVID-19, this is the elephant in the room, brought unprecedented challenges to the world and is not done with us yet. But I'm so proud that the library was right there delivering services throughout. What changes can we hope to see in 2021?
Well, hopefully, we're all hopeful with the rollout of the vaccines that soon and in not too many months, most people will be immunized. And so things can get back much closer to normal. In the meantime, though, we still have the challenge of elevated infection rates mm-hmm. out in the community, mm-hmm. and it will take several months for the vaccine to get to where to as many people as we need it to get to. But in the meantime, we'll maintain some of those protocols and safety measures that we have established this year. They've served us well. I'd like to note that both nationally and then certainly locally in our case, libraries are not a primary transmission point for the virus so far. And part of that is because we have tried to follow the science and put in those kinds of safety measures and protective measures and protocols that will help guard the public when they come to use the library. Some of those things are the quarantine of returned materials mm-hmm. for up to 72 hours, providing hand sanitizing stations, and we like for people to take full advantage of those. We have a regular schedule of building fogging and enhanced cleaning routines. And in addition to that, we have capacity restrictions and some other restrictions, including a slight change in our operational hours mm-hmm. To help us cope with the extra cleaning and that type of thing. But as we get to the point where we can begin to relax those things, we will. And we'll be able to take full advantage. In the meantime, though, there were some things that we developed this year in response, such as the increased number of virtual events mm-hmm. and then also being able to archive events. Mm-hmm. So in the future, as we have more in-person events again and can have those, we'll hope to be able to use it. Because it's one of those great things. There's a terrific program. You just can't get here at 7 o'clock on Thursday night to mm-hmm. see it. But if we record it and then make it available, you can see it on Saturday
People
or Friday
when you
have time.
People are still watching some of the events that we posted earlier in the summer. They're still being watched. So
yes, and we've developed the Career Center's developed some great
wonderful
programs,
videos.
Online programs,
mm-hmm.
video programs that can be very helpful. And our staff throughout the system has worked hard on having things like virtual story times and those kinds of things. So those are all resources that can be used. Hopefully, a lot of people have been introduced to either to using ebooks or in some of our online resources, and they can continue to rely on those. But we're also happy to be able to provide
the books again.
Because people really love books.
Oh, they do.
Yeah.
And once we opened up the stacks for browsing, that was a pain point that we were happy to remove.
Yes, all of us would rather come and browse a book in
sure.
person rather than sometimes it's convenient to browse online and that can work for you, but it really I like it best when I mm-hmm. can take the book down and look at it and say, oh yeah, this book's for me, or maybe right not right now.
Yeah. And by the same token, if you're just not comfortable coming back, we'll still do the shopping for you. We'll still pull the books for you and have them ready for you to pick up in the lobby or at the drive-through
yeah.
window.
Yeah, we want to keep everybody as safe as possible and make things as easy and convenient and as comfortable as possible.
Mm-hmm.
And we will work to that. And that's also with extending some deadlines and making it easier to get a card over
right
the phone or
right.
renewed over the phone. So
yeah,
those
that was
kinds
a big
things.
Change, right?
Yeah.
And we've even reached out to schools, and whole classes are getting computer-only
right.
Library cards. It's
so
really
as,
been great.
As we work towards that magical point where so much of life, including library life, can come back to closer to what it used to be, I think we'll have we'll be able to do all those things that you're familiar with and that you like at the library.
Sure.
But we'll also have some new innovative things or new ways of approaching things and accessing information, materials. So all those things, perhaps in this time frame, people become more familiar with some of those resources. So they can use all those wonderful things that we have all the time, plus some of these newer
right.
things that they've been introduced to.
It's like the Brownie song, make new friends, but keep the old.
Yes.
All right, now you talked about some exciting changes, and to me, capital improvements are the concrete expression of progress for the library, and it's something that people can really see, that because it is concrete. So where are we on our capital improvements program?
Well, this year, despite some of the challenges posed by COVID, we finished the Greenwell Springs renovation mm-hmm. expansion, and we're closing in on finishing up the Jones Creek project. We also have an architectural team in place, a design team that we're working with on the new South Branch Library, along with architectural services in the city.
Mm-hmm.
And so some progress is being made there. We hope within the next couple of months we'll have some concept plans and for that new facility.
That's
to
always
show to
exciting
people.
To yes. see.
And we'll get some community feedback mm-hmm. on what we're looking at. Mm-hmm. In addition to that, we have just gone through the process of selection process for architects for the Scotlandville branch expansion and improvement and the Baker branch. So those are two projects that you'll be seeing more about over the course of this year. Mm-hmm. And on the not too distant horizon, we also have plans for Zachary Central and Delmont Gardens. So all those are in the will be coming into the pipeline over the next couple of years.
It's a very busy time. It just never stops, does it?
No, it doesn't. But as you pointed out, I mean, one of the things that we wanted, we've been so successful with the Fairwood branch and mm-hmm. With the main library and the River Center Library, River Center branch. And they have a lot of features that people like and we use a lot. And we're trying to bring a lot of those things, a lot of those features mm-hmm. and service conveniences to all of our buildings.
Right, dedicated spaces for teens, technology labs, small maker spaces, and of course, those collaborative study rooms
yes.
that we'll be getting back to soon as our COVID arc changes.
Yes.
All right. What's our strategic planning process looking like?
Well, it's time for us to update our strategic plan. We were going to do some of that this year, but we thought that things were a bit disrupted
right.
over the past 6 or 8 months. And so we'll look at that a little bit more closely, but we will focus on those still overarching goals, which is to improve our technology, take advantage of new developments and innovative products, mm-hmm. applications, that kind of thing. One of the things we've been working on, it, we just haven't been able to get a contract yet to help us with some of the website redesign
sure.
and enhancing our
online.
Because
that's our front page to the digital world.
Right, and enhancing our online catalog mm-hmm. and modernizing it and perhaps looking at a new vendor for that product. But we'll continue to work on some of the things that we already have in place too. For example, small business support mm-hmm. and services to entrepreneurs. Our collection development is always an ongoing and important thing. Mm-hmm. And it's not that we always want to keep a strong and hearty and vibrant book collection, but also the ebook collection, mm-hmm. And then the databases and the learning services, those kinds of things, mm-hmm. like we were talking about with the Gale courses and mm-hmm. lynda.com. So all those things are important to us.
Thanks, Spencer. This pace never seems to slow down. After the break, author Allie Wester, plus a book review from one of our younger library patrons. All that and more coming up next on the Library Roadshow. Welcome back to the January edition of the Library Roadshow. Allie Wester is an event planner here in Louisiana, and for more than 25 years, Allie has helped brides plan their wedding day. Allie's written a book entitled The Secret Confessions of a Wedding Planner, a behind-the-scenes guide for brides. This should be a good read. Allie joins me now by phone. Okay, Allie, how did you get your start as an author?
I got started as an author. I've always wanted to write a book. I've been a wedding planner for more than 20 years, and I've always wanted to write a book for brides.
Tell us what this book is really about.
The name of the book is Secret Confessions of a Wedding Planner. It is a guide for brides, sprinkled with really funny stories of all the crazy things I've seen over the past 20 years of being a wedding planner.
What inspired you to write this?
I work with brides, of course, as I said, and I wanted to create a real, honest guide for brides with practical advice. The book is also for moms, mother of the bride, mother of the grooms, bridesmaids, wedding planners, people that want to become wedding planners, because it's going to give them so much information about weddings.
What do you hope readers will take away from your book?
I really want every bride or person that reads the book to go into their wedding with their eyes wide open, that they will have zero surprises on their wedding day. They will go in fully educated, knowing exactly what to expect, the good, the bad, the great, the phenomenal, and that the advice will make their day super spectacular.
How can our viewers learn more about you?
Viewers can find me anywhere on social media. I'm on all platforms, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat, even TikTok, at Weddings by Allie, Allie, or they can visit my website at weddingsbyalliellc.com.
Thanks, Allie. Who doesn't love the excitement and pageantry of a wedding, plus taking us to the back of the house for a fascinating look at the logistical project management side of it all? Don't forget that the library not only has hundreds of books and magazines ready for you to enjoy as you're planning your big day, but also more online. And for fun, just think of all the classic wedding movies and music we offer. It's now time to check in with one of our younger patrons. Find out what they're reading at the library.
My name is Henry. I'm 5 years old. This is my favorite book, and the title is Mrs. Wiggle Wiggle. His mother's getting mad because his father is supposed to be on the bus and on a train, and he's just pretending like it's underwater. It's about kids getting cured. Miss Ashley and Dad bring me to the library, and what was that a question? I like to get a bunch of books from the library. If you read a lot of books, you'll get so smart.
Thanks, Henry. Love hearing from those busy young readers. Stay right there. You're watching the Library Roadshow.
As the nation's doctor, I often get asked, what should I do if I think I might have coronavirus?
People who are sick should stay home. You don't go to an emergency room. You don't go to a clinic. You get on the phone and you ask for advice and instructions from your physician.
We don't want you to go into the ER or the doctor's office without talking to them first, because you might spread coronavirus to someone else. Please visit coronavirus.gov for more information.
Hello, my name is David Lotch. I am the genealogy librarian for the East Baton Rouge Parish Library, and I am talking to you from our department located in the Baton Rouge Room on the second floor of the main library on Goodwood. We are open to the public and are available for in-person consultations and questions. We also have computers for you to use to do your genealogical research. However, some of you may be unable to get here or may not yet feel comfortable being in public. We certainly understand. And that is why we have available many ways to do genealogy from home. All you need is an internet connection and a library card, and you can access an entire world of genealogy. Right now, and through the end of March 2021, Ancestry Library Edition is available from home. The website is user-friendly and intuitive to use, and you do not need to be a member to use all of their databases. In just a few clicks, you can find an enormous number of historical records kept by governments, churches, and other organizations, including census records, birth and death records, marriage licenses, and other records that show the who and the how of families in the past. Right now, they are adding a large number of records from all over Europe, so many people with European roots can now explore their family histories from before the arrival of their immigrant ancestors. Our staff have used these records in their own research, so we are available to help read and interpret the things you may find. Ancestry Library Edition has also added a large number of college and high school yearbooks. These are useful for locating people in a certain place and time. You can also use yearbooks to explore what kind of people your ancestors were. What were their interests? Were they athletes? What kind of clubs did they belong to? And so on. In addition to, and alongside Ancestry, we also encourage genealogists to join FamilySearch. Membership on the site is free, but you do need to sign up with an email address and password. FamilySearch can be a little trickier to use, but they have the advantage of large numbers of images, so you can see the original historical documents as they were written. What's more, FamilySearch allows you to build your family tree on the site. The trees are collaborative, so you may find that somebody else has already done the heavy lifting on some of your ancestors, freeing you up from having to do the work again. Should you run into difficulties or have any questions about these websites or any other topic in your family history, we are available by phone at 225-231-3751 or through email at genealogy@ebrpl.com. Thank you and happy hunting.
You're watching the January edition of the Library Roadshow, a production of your East Baton Rouge Parish Library System. Shout out to the Ancestry. Genealogists have really enjoyed being able to access this powerful resource from home. And did you know there was so much interesting information about the history of Red Stick all under one roof? Come on down and check out those great old maps and photographs. Get expert assistance in researching your own family history and genealogy, or just enjoy a glimpse into Baton Rouge's attic. It's all available at the main library on Goodwood, and it's free with your East Baton Rouge Parish Library card.
Hi, we're here at Breck's Lovett Road Park for their holiday park hop gift giveaway. Let's check it out.
I am Daniel Stute. I am with Breck Community Events. I'm here today giving out Christmas gift boxes to all of the kids. We're giving away gift boxes today. Inside you'll find a coloring book, a Breck bag with goodies in it. You'll find a pencil, the makings for s'mores. You'll find a hot chocolate mix, a bookmark, and a couple other items.
One of those extra things, though not in the goodie bag, is the bookmobile. Jackie Decker with the Library System staffed the bookmobile at this event.
I work at Outreach Services with the library. I'm on the preschool staff, and we go to story times and help check out books to library centers.
You can think of the bookmobile as a bonus library branch, with one very important difference.
Well, with the other branches, you go to the library. With the bookmobile, the library comes to you, and it can be at events or at actual centers or at the park like we are today.
When you enter the East Baton Rouge Parish Library System's bookmobile, you'll find it stuffed full of books and digital media, which include a large DVD collection. Once you find something you like, you can check it out, just like you might at a brick and mortar library branch. The bookmobile really is a library on wheels.
As we come into the new year, this is a great time to book the bookmobile at your community event. Email bookmobile@ebrpl.com and learn more about outreach services by visiting ebrpl.com, Library Services, Outreach.
And now for today's contest, visit the library's Facebook page at facebook.com/ebrpl. The bookmobile is literally library love on wheels. So what are your happy memories of the bookmobile? Pictures are welcome. That's facebook.com/ebrpl. And while you're there, enjoy. We're not your grandfather's library anymore. What's coming up on the Library Roadshow in February? One Book, One Community, of course. We celebrate the Yellow House with a visit from Sarah Broom and Margaret Sexton Wilkerson.
Coming up next month, I'll share another digital resource with you.
I'll visit your community to find out what's happening at your local branch library.
Thanks so much for joining us on the Library Roadshow. And remember, your East Baton Rouge Parish Library is open 7 days a week at each and every one of 14 branches, plus 24/7 on the web. Check us out at ebrpl.com.
And that's how we roll.